बैग पकड़ना है और इलाही मेरा जी आए आए करते निकलते जाना है. Which, by the way, was that fucker Bunny from Ye Jawani Hai Diwani. If that movie had not come in 2013, 2014 when I was graduating, the path of life might have been different. Life goes on in circles from Monday to Friday until you pass out on Friday. Shouldn't be saying these things. Until you pass out on Friday to escape from your reality. So that became a very time-constrained life. Then there was location constraint. That why are we supposed to live in the same city, in the same place all our life and only go for like 3 weeks of vacation in a year and then put a lot of pictures on Instagram to tell everybody that we are living the best life ever. But the reality is we are escaping for 3 weeks. Rest of the 50, 49 weeks, we end up being slave of the system. And lastly, it was financial constraint. कि आपने बहुत आ गया, आपको बहुत कुछ करना है. But the system, the way the system has been built of the corporate world is that your annual salary for that year is decided in advance. आपने एक साथ बहुत जबरदस्त काम किया, अगले साल आपको ठीक है 20% raise मिल गया, बाकियों को अगर 10% भी मिला है, but your annual salary is decided in advance. अब जो मर्जी कर लो, you will end up earning that much. You can be the best performer. You want to do a lot of different things. So on and so forth. So these were the four constraints that were just irritating me, almost suffocating me so much that in late 2016, I gave resignation. Bura haal ho gaya, almost phat jati hai bande ki. That's another thing to just be like so used to this system. It's like dropping out of college. You just feel like karna hi nahi hai drop out because it's so much pressure. So job life equivalent is that when you leave your job without any other source of income yet, is that it's just so much pressure. But very meticulously, I started creating a life where I'm able to break all these four constraints. And of course, the method I chose was using the power of internet to do as many things as possible. I created two brands first. One brand was on Australia Yours because I had recently moved to Australia from Singapore where I was working. And this was new for Australia. I was new in Australia and I realized there are so many other people who are new in Australia as well. So whatever experiences I'm making, a lot of people will relate to that. And that's still the principle I teach today in content creation, that don't try to make anything more than what your reality is, because there are millions of other people who relate to your reality. So I started making content on moving to Australia, making a life in Australia, so on and so forth. And that became a huge brand, huge success. While on the other hand, I was making personal development content on Instagram, which was the mindset I was living. Instagram has always been and it will always be work in progress because my reality and my own mindsets and principles evolve over time with experiences and I share them real time as they're happening. So what was happening in 2018, I used to share on Instagram like that. And again, same thing happened. A lot of people started realizing that these mindsets will help them as well. So they started following those principles, those mindsets, and then Instagram started doing. So that's what I call my personal development brand. And when I had left the job, I had luckily done one thing good that I had created content about how the future of cities will be. The power of the content comes back again in my life, unknowingly this time that I started getting talks to go around and train other government officials into how to plan their future cities, their smart city policies. So by the time it was 2018, you can say about 2 years into my leaving job life, I had three full-blown careers going on in a way that I was doing Australia Yours, I was doing a lot of talks and I was making content on Instagram. And these 2 years then, 2018 and 19, became the years where I had spent between 200 to 250 days traveling and rest of the days in Australia. And just kept working from different places, doing different things. So this is, so far, what you've seen is that a lot of content base, right? So whether it's personal development, whether it's Australia Yours, or whether these are government talks, smart cities, these are all based on one principle of making content. चाहे वो फिजिकल कॉन्टेंट है जाके ट्रेनिंग करना या ऑनलाइन है. सो इनहेरेंटली आई स्टिल ऑल कॉल माई सेल्फ दैट आई एम अ कॉन्टेंट क्रिएटर. ऑल्दो टू मोर थिंग्स हैव बीन एडेड. अगेन वी विल टॉक अबाउट दिस व्हाई यू हैव टू कीप इंक्रीजिंग योर माइंड कैपेसिटी एंड देयर इज एब्सोल्युटली नो लिमिट टू हाउ मेनी करियर्स यू कैन हैव साइमल्टेनियसली बिकॉज अब 5 हैं 2020 एंड में. सो 2 साल और गुजर गए उसके ऊपर. इन्वेस्टमेंट करियर दैट स्टार्टेड about investing in technology, how technology is shaping their lives. That itself has grown into a full-fledged thing that I can now not do anything and just live off the investment returns. And lastly, what is the most recent for the pretty much this year is Digital Nomad Academy, which became mostly, again, reaction to what your reality is, that now my reality had changed for 2018 onwards as someone who is living as a digital nomad. So I was, a lot of people, of course, relate to that and they want to know how to become digital nomad. So now one of the most fun thing that I do for myself is teach digital nomad principles, create content that help people, what I call new working man or new working woman, which in my opinion is the man and woman who works location independently, has no absolute limit on how much they can earn. And they either work for themselves or for clients, but time independently, location independently, financial independently, and almost authority independently as well. So ye pura is tarah ki journey hai. To abhi ho gaye 4 saal takriban is journey mein 2020 ke end pe. Aur jaise jaise the idea of fun keeps evolving, whatever starts seeming like a lot of fun, how the reality seems, how the reality keeps changing as well. Saath saath kaam bhi evolve hota jata hai. So that is, let's say, the introduction.
Sir, that was a story and real story. I loved it. I literally loved it. Like, how can someone imagine this much of evolvement in just 4 years? Like, in just 4 years.
Main batata hun. What I've realized that it is equally difficult to do an easy task as it is to do a hard task. And you can give yourself an example. Main aapko aaj kehta hun ki within 6 months, you have to create a website that can sell e-commerce products. And it will take you 6 months to develop that website that can sell e-commerce products. But agar main aapko kehta hun, within 6 months, you have to make 500 pieces of content. That seems like kaise hoga, but you will still be occupied 8 hours a day or 5 hours a day, whatever, in the first task of making just a website that can sell e-commerce products, which, by the way, is like a weekend task, but it will take you 6 months. And it will take you 6 months to do 500 pieces of content as well. And the realization, of course, now it happened in my life, but I realized it before I even implemented that from Elon Musk, that Elon Musk, Mark Zuckerberg, Tim Cook, Sundar Pichai, Satya Nadella, everybody works equal amount, equally hard. Theek hai, aap argue kar sakte ho, koi 2 ghante kaam, koi 2 ghante zyada karta hai. Lekin just because if Elon Musk can in the same time run 3 different companies, 3 different brands, it's just because he, in his mind, everything is possible. And somebody else's mind running a 1 company is possible. The same mindset between specialization and doing multiple careers. That jo aap apni reality banaoge, aap kahoge ki this is what I want to do, your mind will automatically start thinking ki this is normal. Or it's the capacity is only limited in the mind once you break that. Ab main jaise aaj 5 career hain aur 2017 mein 2 se shuru hua, phir 18 mein 3, aisa nahi hai ki aaj zyada kaam hota hai, pehle kam hota hai. Aaj jo balki matlab bilkul utna hi hai, pehle bhi utna hi kaam tha, abhi bhi utna hi kaam hai. Or this is what you realize as well.
You mean to say that our potential is in our mind, our increment of potential, our end potential, our goal is in our mind, and we can reach through that.
Totally. And how you can do that? Ek to mindset hai. Agar aaj believe kar loge ke your capacity is only limited in the mind, whatever you want to do, it will take equally hard. It will be equally hard even if you want to do an easy task or a hard task. And second is you have to grow the mind's capacity. And this is where I think most people who get inspired to motivational speakers and do not end up changing their life in reality is because wo mind ki capacity usse saab se badha nahi rahe hote, although principle wo le lete hain. Aur capacity kaise badhti hai? Capacity badhti hai through a couple of few things, but let's just put as many as we can think of. Capacity banti hai sabse pehle to have a community. So because we are in a community, so jahan pe the other people are also growing at a freaking rapid pace. अगर वो नहीं है, जैसे ही आपकी कम्युनिटी स्लो हो गई, एकदम से आपका पोटेंशियल स्लो हो गया. सो सबसे पहले आपकी कैपेसिटी बढ़ती है माइंड की. अब मेरे जो 3-4 बहुत क्लोज दोस्त हैं, वो भी बहुत तेजी से प्रोग्रेस कर रहे हैं. तो हमारी जो रोज की लेटेंट थॉट्स होती हैं, द जस्ट द नॉर्मल बैंटर वी हैव ऑन व्हाट्सएप इज इटसेल्फ वेरी एबनॉर्मल एज कम्पेयर टू द नॉर्मल दोस्त जिसके साथ आपने बैठ के सिर्फ शीशा पीना और कार्ड्स खेलने. तो वो एक फर्क हो गया. सेकेंड इज द कॉन्टेंट यू आर अब्सॉर्बिंग थ्रू books, or master classes or courses, whatever, are also by those people who are pushing your limits, making you break your capacity barriers. Yeah, this is different from reading quotes or reading, seeing short viral videos. This is like real investment into hours of investment to courses, master classes, but mostly for me, books. Like people who have like, जिन्होंने अपनी पूरी जिंदगी की कहानी लिख देते हैं एंड देन यू रीड देम, यू अब्सॉर्ब देयर प्रिंसिपल्स एंड योर कैपेसिटी ऑफ द माइंड ग्रोस. एंड थर्डली, नंबर ऑफ अनकॉमन एक्सपीरियंसेस. योर सक्सेस एट एनी स्टेज विल बी डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द नंबर ऑफ अनकॉमन एक्सपीरियंसेस यू डू. जैसे ही कॉमन एक्सपीरियंसेस हो जाएं, जैसे कि कॉमन एक्सपीरियंस है रोज सुबह उठे, पता है कि ये सर्टन रूटीन की टास्क है, ये आज भी करनी है, 6 महीने बाद भी यही करते रहनी है, क्लाइंट्स को ईमेल्स करते रहनी है, सो ऑन एंड सो फोर्थ, जो भी है, वहां पे कैपेसिटी का कैप लग गया ऊपर, बॉटल के ऊपर ढकना डाल के कॉर्क लगा के साइड पे कर दिया. बट जैसे ही अनकॉमन एक्सपीरियंसेस होते जाएं, जिस चीज से लग रहा है कि ये मतलब ये तो बहुत मुश्किल है और ये तो एम्बैरेसिंग है, ये तो मेरी कैपेसिटी से बहुत बाहर है, द नंबर ऑफ अनकॉमन एक्सपीरियंसेस का जो जो योर रैप द ग्रोथ ओवर द ईयर्स बिकम्स अनबिलीवेबल. आप कहते हो यार तीन, आपको वीक टू वीक बेसिस पे नहीं पता चलता, बट मंथ टू ईयर बेसिस पे आप कहते हो आई हैव कम सो फार अहेड, आई कांट इवन बिलीव इट. सो जो भी चीज लगे कि यार ये तो गलत है, मतलब ये अनकंफर्टेबल है, ये ठीक नहीं है, वो तो करनी है. Or and that does not have to be monetary or work related. That has to do with social settings, with trips, with adventures, with trying on different fashion that makes you look embarrassing, trying out singing, music, whatever that is.
That's clearly awesome, sir. That's amazing. Because I just analyzed it that we are also doing it subconsciously, like unconsciously, I would say, because talking about the enrollments in this Road to Exhibition program, the first time we took around 2 months, the second time we took around 1 month, and there was a moment in a particular batch where we had just 7 days, like in this batch only, for this batch only, which is running right now, batch 5, we had just 7 days, no option to leave it any side, and we had to get the enrollments in 7 days. We got the maximum enrollments in 7 days compared to any of the batches where we took 1 or 2 months. In just 7 days, we took the maximum enrollment. So definitely the potential is in our head and we can maximize it according to us. That's awesome.
Very true. Very true.